Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of the Gamers Podcast. Now, just in advance, I am very sick. I am stuffy. My voice probably sounds different because I'm sick. I'm just sick. So I'm not probably going to sound the best in this video, but this is a very important video that I especially wanted to make today. So I am just super sick. So if I sound, you know, different and my voice isn't the best as it usually is, just please excuse me. That's what's going on. But it is a very big, big video. Now, this is one of the podcasts where I'm going to do a two-in-one. Like, usually, I'll just pick a topic to talk about on a podcast, and I'll stick to it. But usually, because there's so much stuff to talk about, usually if there's, like, two big things happen, maybe in, like, 1 week, I'll do, like, a two-in-one. So we'll be talking about two different things today, which is the 2023 Game Awards, which we talked about the Game Awards last year, and GTA 6, the trailer finally dropped. It actually dropped early because it got leaked. So it dropped, what was it, Monday night instead of Tuesday, which is, you know, whatever, we got it early. But we'll be talking about that, and we'll also be talking about the Game Awards. So we talked about the Game Awards last year, and we'll be talking about that the very first thing. So we got a big podcast episode to talk about, and GTA 6 being one of the biggest things. But I'll go into the Game Awards first. So, much to discuss. So, the Game Awards this year weren't the best. I watched it like I did last year with some friends, and it wasn't the best Game Awards. Like, last year's was really, really cool, and, you know, because it was actually the first time I started watching it, fully, and it wasn't the best this year. I'll be honest with you, it wasn't the best. Baldur's Gate 3 won the Game of the Year, which I never, I'll be honest with you guys, I never really heard of that game. You know, after it won, I looked it up and saw some stuff. I don't really have too much to comment on the Game of the Year. I mean, it is what it is. There were some funny moments in there, you know, that I really enjoyed. But there wasn't really too much to talk about. None of the games that I was really too interested in really won any, you know, thing. Now, The Last of Us, the HBO series, it won Best Adaptation of a Game, which, you know, I mean, that's pretty cool. Because I did like that, but there's also nothing really too major that I really saw about, but, you know, it was always nice. You know, it is very nice to watch a Game Awards, even if there wasn't really anything too crazy that happened or anything, like, you know, any of the games that I really enjoy, played. There was Spider-Man 2 that, well, it was nominated for 6 different awards, the Spider-Man 2 game, and it was nominated for 6 different awards, and it didn't win not one of them. So that was also a thing, which I'm surprised about. I thought it would win something. I wasn't really thinking it would win Game of the Year, but it didn't win anything. So, which I'm very surprised about. A lot of the games, like, they were shown, like, trailers and whatnot, like they do show, they were just indie games, and they didn't really talk too much about GTA 6, which is, you know, we're also gonna be talking about the GTA 6 trailer. They didn't really talk too much about that at all, which I'm surprised. I mean, there's not too much to go off of. There's just the trailer, but I'm surprised they didn't really talk too much about that. And I actually thought Rockstar was going to do, well, at first, I thought they were going to, like, instead, you know, before they announced the trailer coming out, you know, on Twitter, I thought they were actually going to announce it or come out with a GTA trailer or something with GTA 6 on, you know, at the Game Awards, which would be pretty cool. But they didn't. Obviously, it came out before that, but they didn't really talk about that too much. Nothing really too interesting happened, I'll be honest with you guys. It was, like, all the trailers were, like, indie games. Nothing too crazy, so that's kind of my review on the Game Awards. It wasn't that exciting, not like last year, because Elden Ring won the Game of the Year, and that was a big thing, but nothing really too crazy happened. So, my review on the Game Awards, it wasn't the best Game Awards, but, you know, It's around. So, you know, it's just something I want to talk about. I said last year when I made that for the 2022 Game Awards, I said that I would maybe make another podcast on, you know, talking about it, and I did. Here it is. So, that's pretty much all I have to say about the Game Awards. Now, to move on with the bigger thing is the GTA 6 trailer dropped. Now, I'm not really going to be reading off of a script or an article. I'm kind of going to be giving my raw thoughts. Now, I have seen, like, what people have to say about GTA 6. Most of it is good feedback. Like, most of it, like, I'm super hype about it. And, you know, a lot of other people are super hype about it since it came out. A lot of people are talking about it, of course. But maybe not everybody. There has been some complaints that I've, been seeing, but so we'll get into that. But the GTA 6 trailer dropped, and I'm actually going to show it here to you guys if you guys haven't seen it, and I'm kind of going to break it down. No, I have seen it. I've actually watched it a couple times to study it, but I'm going to show it here just because it's received over, what, I think like 300 million views, and that's just as much as the GTA 5 trailer got when it came out, and I think it actually surpassed Mr. Beast in some way for his amount of views. So I'm going to show it here, then we'll come back and talk about it. I'm sure you guys have already seen it, but just for good measures, I'll show it here.
Lucia, do you know why you're here?
Bad luck, I guess. Who's back? The only way we're gonna get through this is by sticking together, being a team. Trust?
Trust.
That was a great trailer. Now, I have so much to talk about, like I said, because I've watched it quite a few times at this point. Now, first and foremost, it is coming out in 2025, and so that's very soon, so we'll be getting into that, but 2025, it's coming. Now, out of all of the fake GTA 6 trailers, the fake stuff I've seen, this is a GTA 6 trailer confirmed, not clickbait. Out of all the fake GTA 6 trailers I've seen, that, their claim it's clickbait, it's fake, whatever. This is the authentic GTA 6 trailer. Of course, it's from Rockstar Games themselves. And it looks great. I can't really believe that it's real, but it's actually here. Now, out of all the years that we've waited, it's been like a decade since GTA 5. Out of all the years we've waited, it's been a long time. And it looks so fun. Like, it's based in Vice City. Once again, it's based in Vice City, as we could see there. Our main character is Lucia and her boyfriend, from what I could see and what I've heard. So there are two main characters, and looks like there's so much to do in Vice City. Looks like there's, like, you go to the Everglades, there's, like, swamps and stuff and like that. Apparently, there's, like, an alligator. People were talking about the alligator there going into the store. There's, like, a bunch of cool stuff. There's cops. There's all kinds of stuff that it seems like you could really do, and it seems like it's going to be one of Rockstar's, like, biggest worlds. It's going to be a super free world, like, more than GTA, GTA 5. Like, GTA 5 is also expansion, but, like, with the PS5 now, they have the next-gen consoles with the PS5, they could probably push it harder than they already did with GTA 5, so it's going to be absolutely amazing, and I can't wait for it to come back, come out. It's gonna look fun. It's definitely gonna be fun, and I am so excited, and a lot of other people are excited for it. They were talking about the relation to GTA 5 and GTA 6, and they're talking about, like, if there's gonna be any mentions of it, and I'm sure there will be. And that is just a great trailer, and of course Rockstar outdid themselves with it, and a lot of people have been getting mad at Rockstar for not putting it out, whatever, but they absolutely did great on this, as always. I knew they would be coming around. So now, I love this trailer as long as everybody else, but not everybody. So a lot of people that I've seen have been getting mad that it's coming out in 2025. Now, here's my issue with that. First of all, let's see. It's December of 2023. So let me see here. It's going to be 2024 in like a month. And we're just about there. So we have to wait 2024, and then it's said that it's going to come out like January or February of 2025, so we really don't have to wait too long, even in 2025. But a lot of people are complaining, like, 2025, you know, I disagree with that. That's, you know, I'd rather them, you know, make a good game, you know, and, you know, have it come out later than, you know, earlier. So, because, you know, that's what we've seen with games. Games are rushed, they're released too quick, and they're just not good games at all. So, I would rather Rockstar take their time with this one, especially, and because it's GTA 6, after all. And, you know, you could say that, oh, well, we've waited, like, almost, you know, we've waited, like, a decade and then some for GTA 5. Well, to be honest, how much of us, like, there hasn't been any kind of GTA 6 material, like, confirmed. Like, there hasn't really been a trailer like this. Like, so, for all I knew, you know, for all everybody knew, there wasn't going to be a GTA 6. You know, there was never going to be a GTA 6. They could have came out with Bully 2, which I wouldn't complain about that. But they could have come out with any kind of game and just ditched the whole Grand Theft Auto series as a whole. I mean, you know, we don't know that. So the first actual, you know, evidence, of course, and confirmation of GTA 6 coming out was this past Monday. So, you know, I don't look at it as people have waited that long because nothing is coming out. It's not like they came out with this trailer in 2016 and then we've been waiting, you know, like it's been, you know, it's just been a couple days is the way I look at it. So it's not that far away. Everybody can be patient, I think. I know everybody's excited, but we can be patient. So I agree with that. And just looks like a super fun trailer. That's what everybody seems to complain about is the release date. But it's right around the corner when you think about it. It's really not that far. So it looks absolutely fun. It looks like there's going to be a lot of different cars. I hear like So, like, the map's going to be a lot bigger, and it's just what we've all been waiting for years and years and years. And it's finally here. So, that's pretty much going to do it for this episode. I just want to hop on here and talk about GTA 6, because and the Game Awards, of course, we have that go on. But this was a pretty big podcast. There's a lot going on in the gaming world right now. So, comment down below. Well, what did you guys first think of the Game Awards? Did you guys think that Baldur's Gate 3 deserved the Game Awards, you know, the Game of the Year Award? And any of the other nominees, discuss that. And then GTA 6, what did you guys think of the GTA 6 trailer? I know a lot of people are definitely excited for it. Do you guys think that 2025 is too long from now? I personally don't think that, but, you know, whatever it may be. So comment down below, let's discuss all that. I know I'll be getting GTA 6. It's going to be kind of weird because, you know, it's like when you see those memes when it's like, when you try to buy GTA 5, and it's like, you need a parent to buy this game, sir. Then it's like, GTA 6, you cash your card, sir.
Tell you one thing, T. I'm getting too old for this nonsense.
Makes me feel really old. Really, really old. And I know a lot of other people, too. Just makes me feel super old. So, we got GTA 6, it's coming, 2025, and if anything else comes out, which I'm sure they'll have tons of trailers come out, I'll of course do a follow-up. I'm sure they'll have a lot of stuff planned for 2024, like other things that they'll be talking about, like, you know, maybe, you know, they'll go through the different characters or whatever. So if there is anything else about GTA 6, I'll certainly be on coming on a podcast and talking about it all the way up to the release date. With that being said, I'm super hyped. Make sure to subscribe for more content, like the video, all good stuff, Discord, Twitch, Instagram, links in the description. And I'll see you guys in the next video, and get hyped for GTA 6.